We have arrived here at Manaflow. We're going to go in, talk a little bit about exhausts, and get one, I suppose. And off we go. Oof. E30, that'll be the next project car, boys. And we got Salisbury Ass Centre in front of us. Nice. So, we're in Salisbury taking a trip back to... I think I'm clear my side. Yeah. Taking a trip back to Whoa! There's fucking this 500 goes fast. Don't anybody tell you anything different. And we're on our way back to Hampshire now. Well, we're in Hampshire, you know what I mean. Winchester. Hometown. I'll see you when we get home to fit this exhaust. Bye-bye. Hi, guys. It's me, Tom. You join me on a particularly wet owl. Is that what you all think of me? Yeah, so we went down to a certain place, and we brought back this. So I'm going to do a quick unwrapping. I know you can't wait to see what it is. So if we start... Oh my god, guys, can you tell what it is, yeah? I used to be kind of like a surgeon back in the day. Just wearing paint now. Oh. I thought I was never wrapping. Is this where we wrapped it? Well, the paint would still work. That's fine. Ooh! I'll do the last bit, and I bet... If you know what it is, drop a comment down in the... in the comments, and let me know. Let me know that you know that you're smarty. Ooh. Yes, got a lovely scratch right down in frame with the breathing blade. I didn't really. Where we go, guys? Here it is. If you couldn't tell before, you can tell now. They got a scratch I put right down. Thank God I'm not a mechanic anymore. So this is a 1 3/4 inch back box, Manaflow of course. I don't know why you'd actually, imagine having an RC40. And it's also got a megaphone on. I don't know what it does. Actually, I do know what it does. Basically, you see the canister, that kind of sucks. If you turn it around, it creates back pressure. They use it on race exhaust to take gas out faster, basically. I told Matey, this is a race car, heavily, historic, genuine Coupe Mark 1, with a highly tuned engine. He said, I know just what to fetch you up. A slice of reality, he said, no. So this is what we got, we're gonna bang it on in a minute now, and work out these. I don't have a rear beam in mind, so we'll have to figure it out, drill some holes. So yeah, we'll crack on, I suppose. Oh yeah, they also... Actually, I'm quite open with my viewers. So I think what I'm going to do is tell them about how much it costs. Hold on, hold all me details. 148 quid. And the bloke doing it didn't have... The bloke doing it didn't have all the parts in stock. Which is... God, I'm getting a bit camera pressure here. So the guy... He was doing it, I said what I wanted, and he said, oh, give me 10 minutes, and he built it from scratch. Check this out, guys. Guys, check this out. See this? He built that, and that's his signature there. His fingerprints. Top guy. I really appreciate it. I would have got his name, but I didn't, and I would have filmed it, but I'm not rude, and I realise these guys are doing a good job. What else can I say? So... I suppose we can carry on. So I've just copper slip that, slides on easy. And now, when I say I'm going to do the work, Nick May's going to do the work. Here you go, Nick.
I always thought these... This is a heavy back box. I'm only getting a barrel to sit this on.
They're all attacked beautifully.
Now we're just going to use a bit of nut lock. By a bit, I mean quite a lot. That is medium. Medium nuts a lot. Hey, do you want to put my jack up a little bit?
That's not what I'm paying for. You guys, the exhaust is on. Nick's gone home. I'm sad about that. There might be a few things in exhaust that might need to be redone. I didn't use any you know what I mean, what's it called, that paste stuff, exhaust gunk, exhaust, you know what I mean, that white sheet on. I don't use that because it goes hard and cracks, and if you've actually got a gap and it cracks, it'll work its way out, turn into dust. I always use silicone RTV. It's high temperature, it's good, holds, and it's flexible, so it actually makes it a better seal, I find anyway. So I might need to go back under and take a few joints apart and do that, but I think I'm just going to send it for the time being. All the pipes are like in each other by at least 4 inches, so like 8, and some of them are lapping over by 8. Let's turn it around. Here it is, center exit. I wasn't sure if that's what I really wanted, but I've done it now. I've never had one before. I need to make a bracket for this. I don't really want to have to get anything out fabrication wise, so guys don't hate me, but I might even nip down to the local B&Q and see kind of what pre-made brackets they have out of stainless, because not only will I make it out of mild steel, it'll probably just rust. I just can't remember to make anything. It sounds bad, but here's what it is. Oh god, sorry for dropping the camera. I'll just get a little oil bracket and bolt it to the floor and then put a spacer under there. And then that'll be hidden by the tank, so I'm not too worried, that'll look good. Obviously it's a bit difficult mounting this because I don't have a rear subframe, I've just got a beam axle. So I've used that house roller block thing. Bolted either side there and there. I think you saw, I've got a video of it, me mounting that, and just a normal nut and washer there, which I'm going to get a spring washer for. That, look how good, let me crawl under. Oh, look how good the gap is on that rubber. It's just clearing that peak, like, it's brilliant. And it's got the megaphone, I'm pretty sure that's the right way around. Can't see it being the other way around, to be fair to you. And it just goes up, megaphone, straight pipe. Or reverse megaphone, sorry. Down to my what's the majigger? Pipe's a bit of an angle on that join from the downpipe. So that is the only thing I can see that needs to be split and sealed. But that's okay because it falls into place really easily, but it's in there for now. I'll go back through, and if there's any issues I'll address it at a later date.